Hello, my name is Manuel Blackschmidt. In this video, I'm going to show how to send a sign and upload bundles message to the ERPS app application through the WebSocket. So we have the WebSocket client, we have the sign and uploads bundles message, and this goes to the WebSocket. Then internally, lots of things are happening, and in the end, the internal system sends back a ERPS with documents message. And this message contains, again, all the bundles, including an access code and also a PDF document. And we have a test case prepared for that. So there is a WebSocket XML prescription client test, and I'm now using the prescription sign and uploads bundles test case. So what does it do? It first reads an example file. It reads the sign and uploads bundles JSON file. Then it replaces the UUID because the bundle has to be unique. And then it sends the message to the WebSocket. And it waits a second, and then afterwards it's closing the WebSocket. So on this particular example, I enable the write PDF file property. So this will make sure that the ERPS application is writing all the PDF files that are created into the file system, because this particular client that I just showed you, it's closing faster than the reply is coming. So therefore, the reply won't be sent to this client. But we can see the client, the response on the console. So therefore, I can show you this answer. So now I will also give you a brief heads up for this file itself. So this is the whole message. So it starts with the type sign and upload bundles. It's a JSON message. Then it contains an array of arrays. And basically, for every entry in the array, it will create one ERPS with documents message, and the array itself they can contain up to three bundles. So the bundle, it's a normal e-prescription bundle. You can see this here, and this particular bundle, it's a normal medication. It's a medication request, and it has a medication, and I think it's Prospan Hustensaft. So let's just check this out. So there is the medication, the resource type is medication, and there you can see it's Prospan Hustensaft. And now I'm going to show you how this works. So I'm clicking here on run. So now this is connecting to the currently running server on my machine. I can also show you the running server. It's here and it's already done. So here you can see the base64 encoded PDF file. And here you can see how it worked. So there was lots of processing. In the end, PDF was generated. The PDF was saved into the file system. And this is the ERPS with documents answer. And you can see here that this is the access code that was generated. Here's the whole bundle again. The important thing is this prescription ID. So the access code and the prescription ID, these are the two things that you really need to get as a pharmacy this e-prescription from the Fachdienst. And then also here's the base64 encoded PDF. And I will show you this PDF. So it's here. And this is what we generated. So there's the Prospan Hustensaft, two times a daily, 5 milliliters. And this is for Ingrid Erbprinzessin, and it was made by Dr. Maximilian Weber, who is a pediatric, I think this is the name of Kinderarzt in English. But feel free to put the real name of Kinderarzt into the comments. Thanks a lot, and see you in the next video.